You are now watching Black Club TV.
By many, hated by plenty, disliked by some, but confronted by none. I thought poetry tap used to be a Christian. Words spoken by ears that never listen. Using Facebook statuses to do their dissing. But when they see me in the streets, you know what they kissing. It's like they on their knees to the point you would have thought it was pimping. I don't even call them haters no more. I call them clumsy because they tripping. Listening to my CDs, no skipping. My critics about to have dumb luck. Because I'm going to leave a punch drunk like my flow is a rock and they've been doing too much sipping. I got some shit cooking in the kitchen. Don't try to smell, just listen. We got poets in the game freestyling, but making no sense. I guess that's why they be having shows, but making no sense. And since they fail to put the time in, I guess I'll chime in to put my, take that time and a half to put my grind in. Cause like my bro Geronimo say, if you ain't grinding, then you won't be shining. See, like love, this poetry scene can be so blinding. So like love, whenever I see the hymen, I just wave as I walk past on my way to the money like, hi, man. I do this full time. Full time is how I do this. I had to quit my job, just check the email since. And since that moment, I've been seeing poets in the unemployment line just to pay to get on stage to say they also quit. I respect the open mic scene, but never needed it. I was once told that it could help me out, but I didn't believe in it. Truth be told, most poets that I meet are old, garbage, and lethargic. Meanwhile, I just bought a new car because I'm one hell of an artist. And I ain't even one of the hardest. So if you took offense to this, then yes, it's about you and we know where your heart is. But you want to know what the funny part is? Half these niggas think they the shit, barely be farting.
Y'all remember the rest of it.
Oh, there we go. I spit truth that'll send you over the ledge. Like, yes, that is my extra kissing. But she's still giving me head. And she's tasting the pussy of another bitch who got a husband but decided to fuck me instead. So those little player lines that you kick in your pieces, that shit is dead. Oh, what a tangle where we weave. Cause I still know enough Bible to convince your pastor to believe that my birthday is on 3/16 because God so loved the world that he gave you me. And that may have sounded like blasphemy, but think about it. I make women want to forget about their past for me. And whenever you want, whenever you need a blessing, it's hard for you to pass on me. See, I'm not the equivalent to Jesus, but I keep a few soldiers ready to blaspheme. They say poetry tap is arrogant with a foul mouth. But they need me in the clutch because I never foul out. Plus, like Kobe without Shaq, I just ball out when I go all out. Spit an erotic piece to make your girl want to fall out. And I catch niggas taking notes about me on their Galaxy phones, but I never get called out. I keep the game in the headlock, they may as well tap out. I turn haters into beat makers from the way that they tap out. Been shot, I bled, was supposed to be dead, but instead I'm still here, so I guess there's nothing left to be said except taps out, and that's that piece.
You said I'm racist? So we don't keep it moving. This young lady, I didn't even know she could spit, like, you feel what I'm saying, or whatnot. I know I seem like a groupie, like, I was getting to that point. I know I seem like a groupie, because I was like, hey, hey, and then we knew each other, and then when I heard you spit, I'm like, hey, Soul Freak, what up? Like, hello? Like, you dope? How you doing? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. No, it was just, I don't know, I'm sorry. It was 10 years ago, like, come on, man. I don't remember what I did yesterday. So, give it up to this young lady. She is about to kill it. You want a microphone or no? Okay, no? See? Okay. All right, give it up for Soul Freak.
That's because
she's farting.
Anywho. I erased you because from my mind I want to remove every trace of you because I'm tired of tracing you. Using you as the outline for the next person in line only to replicate the same mistakes and never really raise the stakes. So I'm deleting you.
Come on, baby.
So I don't care how many times it takes for me to hit backspace, I need you gone from my database to the point where just the mention of your name sends a message to my brain that reads error. Does not compute, system crash, no way to reboot.
Come on.
Every memory, every dream, every reality, every opportunity for you to make the world seem a little more dimly lit to me. I'm bleaching out every pain, every spot, every stain, and I'll be so thorough that you'll probably get nauseous from the ammonia fragrance that I sprayed. Just call me Dexter because like his victims from my life, you will simply fade.
Come on.
And a neurologist, he'll probably diagnose me with selective Alzheimer's, but I don't care. As long as it keeps me from seeing a psychologist for treatment for this relationship PTSD, because these memories of you and me are constantly haunting me. My dreams have become my worst nightmare, you see. I'm in need of serious brain surgery, removal of the hippocampus so I can finally sleep peacefully without you waking me, because I can't keep waiting on this time that is taken for the depletion of these neurons that have your face perfectly framed are driving me mentally insane. So I decided to destroy the myelin sheath that you laid so there's no more synaptic connections that lead to these silly girl reminiscences. I'm sorry. Let me put this in layman's description. I want you gone. Don't care for my thoughts if you just magically come up missing. They'll call it amnesia of the heart. 1, 2, 3, clear. It's time to restart because it was all a lie. I'm tired of you living this farce. And I was told that you can't build something new on top of a graveyard.
Come on.
I guess because there's too many unhealed scars. So I decided that I'm rewriting my story. I put the pen to the paper, purge, and get all of you out of me because you shall not be featured in this autobiography.
What? What?
So I'm erasing you because I'm tired of hating you. So you're released now. Third.
Come on.
His name was Bass. Bass guy. That's what they call him. Like, who the hell is a bass guy? What is that? Basically, what bass means is you just get up there and say whatever come to mind. That's what a lot of these dudes like Chief Keef and Lil Durk and Lil Herb, all them guys, they just get in the studio and they just talk about what's going on right then, right there. So I don't even know what I'm about to say. So y'all might find this as a treat, or you might like it, might dislike it. But I'm finna go ahead and try to do something. Alright? So I'm just gonna go ahead off the top of the head. I wake up in the morning and I ask myself, I love pop, so I say, should I blast myself? Should I keep going? Should I stop? Should I lay down and die? If I do that, when I get to heaven, God gonna be like, why? I gave you what you needed, but what did you do? I told you to go plant those seeds, but what did you do? I say to myself, that I know that I'm more than just a nigga. Shout out to my homie right here. I know that I'm more than a nigga. Even though when I walk into the room, they don't understand me. Cause I've been misunderstood like Lauryn Hill. Shout out to all my Haitians, my refugees, all my people in the hood. We gotta put our minds together. Cause we dying and there's too much blood being shed in the streets. These kids ain't got no direction. But see me, I know that if I open up my mind, that I could give them maybe just a little bit of direction. I could tell them where I've been, tell them where I'm at, and tell them where I'm trying to go. I open up my mind, and who knows which way the wind will blow. That's the way that I'm gonna flow. I got kids at home, I got boys, they gotta look up to me. They looking up to me. I got kids at home, my boys, they looking up to me. My little brother doing time in the joint down in Florida because I misled him, but I can't go out that way. So what I'm gonna do right now is go ahead and switch over to something that I wrote, because the freestyle, it ain't really coming like that, like I thought it was, you know? All right, so check it out. I say, where I'm from, ain't nobody got no college degree. I'm from the slums, I'm from the bottom. where they're starving to be. On the city from Chicago, trying to follow their dreams to be a star, because it's hard to get up out of them streets without a wicked jump shot and hit the lottery, see. Niggas doing robberies to get the dollars for me. I just wanna be one of the rawest MCs. Use music to keep shorties up out of the streets. Motivational speaker, this is ghetto poetry. If I die, then how long would they mourn me? Money never made the man, a man made the money. It's funny how every time that one of us make it, one of us will get killed, or one of us will get taken to the state pen. They left the hood, but the hood never left them, because they just want success, and that's it. See, what God has given to us, we got to give it back. So that's what I'm going to do right now. You know what I'm saying? All right. It started with the slave trade in West Africa. 400 years after the massacre, we attacking the crooked government and its crooked ass Republicans. The Democratic Party ain't done ish for the government. Ain't done ish for the brothers and sisters of the struggle. Ish but trouble. When they slipped up, but trouble. When they slipped into the jungle and kidnapped the Africans, our ancestors, and through the middle passages, we was traveling. Through the triangular slave trade, the slaves made it with the natives. New races and nations were created like Jamaicans, Dominicans, Cubans, and Haitians, Puerto Ricans, Barbadians, Panamanians. We all came on slave ships. It's been 400 years and we still ain't made it yet. We still oppressed but refuse to accept anything less than what's doing to your death. Man, it's time for a revolution. I'm mixing rap and poetry right now. It's time for a revolution. Time to wear your boots and lace up. Can't wait for the resolution. Black troops don't shoot if you ain't gotta use it. We gotta do this. It's a movement. I said it's time for a revolution. Time to wear your boots and lace up. Can't wait for the resolution. Black troops don't shoot if you ain't gotta use it. We gotta do this through the music. It's just a lie. Ain't no way to justify how they locked us in them chains and they beat us just to try to destroy our culture. They hit our soul you like a vulture, pour roasters out them holsters and smoked our loyal soldiers. They said we was animals, separated families. Over 5 million casualties in the Atlantic Sea. You gotta see the aftermath. This tragedy happened fast. How them cowards overpower blacks and we ain't have a chance. Fast forward to the 30s and the 40s. The Ku Klux Klan was around, but we was only promised 40 acres and a mule, but we were tortured. We built churches all down south and then they torched them. Burned crosses on front lines and hanging corpses. It was the forces of evil that made our people cautious and conscious. Trying to live with that up on our conscience. Our continent was conquered by Caucasians and communists. It's time for a revolution. Time to wear your boots and lace up. Can't wait for the resolution. Black troops don't shoot if you ain't gotta use it. We gotta do this through the music. My last verse. The Jim Crow laws in the 60s had us marching. Hold up. The Jim Crow laws in the 60s had us marching. Behind Malcolm X, Marcus Garvey, and Dr. Martin. Dogs barking with the law watching. With the law watching. Locked on target, armed with a baton on a mission to stop our progress. They beat us but can never defeat us. They never treated us equal. Never seen us as people. There was a sequel to the civil rights. Freedom fighters, righteous and young. Black men screaming black power, rifles and arms by any means. Dressed in fatigue, there was a team called the Black Panther Party who was causing the scene. But the man got scared, went ahead and sent the feds, and the Central Intelligence Agency had a plan. They assassinated all the heads and locked the rest in chains. From the docks to the block, they dropped their cocaine. And 40 years passed and we lacking guerrilla tactics. It's time for action. It's time for blacks to be activists. It's time for a revolution. Time to wear your boots and lace up. Can't wait for the resolution. Black troops don't shoot if you ain't gotta use it. We gotta do this. It's a movement. Off the top, man. Oh, man.